equipment for Lafayette.
Looks like we won't be joining the party.
I can see why this place is the stuff of cautionary bedtime stories.
Not to mention why the Abbey's keeping way the hell away.
We shouldn't let our guard down. But this place could still be a good chance to hone our combat skills.
Indeed. Most everything we've fought here seems to follow a pattern. This is a good place for tactical training.
If we ever end up on another island like this one, we should probably come prepared for the kinds of enemies we'll face.
Eleanor is down one blast because I had to switch.
We came out with pretty good resources, though, I'd say.
Eleanor's boots were the only thing we've mastered. Though we have other things we could look at.
Those have good stats for the most part.
She probably has the lowest pair to learn.
Oh.
That focus plus 5, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we got an extra pair of floric boots.
2 floric dolls. We got a bunch of equipment for Lafayette and Magaloo. We're gonna need to totally remap our characters with that Ventite, though.
That's a good point. Okay, where do I need to go? This is...
Yseult is the story progression, correct?
Yeah, but I was gonna go grab the first piece of the... It's... Okay. That's where it is. Bester Tunnels.
It's in Kurogane's workshop?
Yep.
I'm gonna use the restroom, I'll be right back.
Sure, you notice too, the way this game organizes your quests is really handy, where it just shows them to you on the map, and then if you click on them, it shows you where to go in the world to do them.
Oh, by the way, the cats we get in here are going to be enough to go right back to that island and open that chest.
Yeah, that's kind of what my plan was. Treasure chest refilled. We now have some balmy fluid. How many was that cat's chest again?
It was, I think, 105. I think we already have enough. I know it wasn't one of the unusually expensive ones. It's not bad to have more just because we're gonna run into another cat's chest. Probably at the port. You know?
Yep. Yseult's a pretty big town. By the way, the next story dungeon is, McClear Beach. You know, the demo.
Yeah. After we do shopping in the next town, we should probably do another round of upgrading equipment. Because we found a lot of materials and, you know,
yeah,
the benefits are substantial. If we get characters up to, like, plus 5, you know, that's an extra blast they can hold.
That was interesting how that enemy didn't react.
Cave is so massive.
This might be a good candidate for a,
Yes, we're using a bottle to get out of here.
That enemy type's hilarious, too, with how slow it moves. Remember when you fought a group of enemy types like that with, Lila and her Crucible?
There's a good chance to heal. Navigating one dungeon gets you so many cat souls.
This is really like pretty, like the biggest dungeon in the game that we've been through so far.
It's just a nondescript cave.
In all fairness, the nondescript caves are slightly more distinct.
This is a boring cave, no matter what game it's in.
Remember how brown and bland most of the caves were in Berseria?
Yeah, this cave's so much better. It's blue and bland.
I like blue.
The materials in his workshop were pretty good last time we looted them. Yeah, they're all crafting materials.
This must be Long Dao's dust. The ingredient Videl's Omega Elixir recipe calls for.
I can't believe you actually found it.
We have to go tell Videl. Maybe he's been able to translate the rest of the list.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've done all of the hunts so far.
Where are you going?
That is a good point. Do you want to go to the bridge ravine?
Oh yeah, that sounds like a great idea.
Oh yeah, we leveled from the last boss fight. I should have fixed this.
We have a lot of things we need to fix. I assume we're gonna do shopping in the next town, and we'll have to remap all our arts and everything.
Yeah.
Because the item we got from that arena completely changes the game. Because it lets you assign four arts to just inputs you can use whenever you want. Which, obviously, are going to be your four best, most used arts. Which means you'll remap your normal inputs to everything else. The chest.
Oh.
It's too bad that wasn't the real Eifried. But I'm glad everyone on the ship is feeling better.
Yeah. Though it sounds like they never want to touch that Salatoma stuff ever again.
What about Eleanor?
She took it too. And her face went all... Wah!
I don't mean how she looked. I mean how she actually feels.
Oh. Well, she looks like she feels better too.
Good.
You're worried about her, aren't you, Velvet?
No. It's nothing like that.
Let me tell you something, kiddo. When young maidens ripen, they have trouble expressing their feelings.
So Velvet's... ripen?
Mogilu! Quit giving Loppyset confusing thoughts!
No trouble expressing those feelings, I see.
The Abbey is supposed to exist to bring peace and order to the world. Everything the Abbey does, everything Lord Melchior and Shepherd Artorias do, it ought to be rooted in that mission. And yet, something just doesn't feel right here.
You are dismissed. That knowledge is not for you.
Something wrong?
Whoa! Easy there. Just asking.
Sorry. I was just deep in thought. Is there something you need from me?
Nah. Just heard a bunch of sighs and wondered if you were feeling sick or anything.
No, I drank my Salatoma juice.
Ah. Tasted like crap, didn't it?
It wasn't that bad.
Hey.
What?
Are you afraid of demons?
No, I am not. It's more like I despise them. 10 years ago, a group of them attacked my village. They destroyed everything. And everyone.
Including your family?
Yes. The only family I had at that point was my mother. And in all the chaos, she... All I have left of her is this hand mirror she gave me. I didn't want anyone else to have to feel the way I did. And so I became an exorcist in order to destroy demons. So you can keep your pity.
Gotcha. I will then.
And thus we immediately get back on the ship.
After more scenes.
What is that?
That's called a pangyon, a type of bird native to this area.
Pangyon.
Their meat is succulent and tender, and makes a lovely stew.
Wow, what's it taste like?
You'd eat that poor thing? Savage.
You're one to talk, demon. It was one of my mother's specialties.
All right, enough of the chit-chat. Mogilu, what's this grimoire friend of yours like?
Well, how do I put it? Oh. know, like that.
Like what?
Well, to put it in a way those of meager imagination can understand, Grim's got a sort of listless, aristocratic air about her. A noblewoman in her twilight, you could say.
Huh. So you mean, like, a woman, but different from Velvet and Eleanor.
You're not wrong there. Tell you what, just keep an eye out for a grown woman.
Grown woman. Okay, I got it.
Well, since we got her name, we could start by asking around.
Exactly. Now you're talking. What's up, kiddo?
Moggy Lou, you're a grown woman yourself. So why is it you have trouble clearly expressing your real feelings?
Good question. Put simply, a long time ago, mine broke. Bagow! Chapoom! Bye-bye!
Your feelings broke?
Come on. Let's question the townsfolk.
Let's get on our ship. Well, let's order our ship to sail somewhere else and then immediately board it.
I mean, it's a different ship. It's the ship from the beginning of the game that we repaired. Yeah, we need to go pick up the... We've got a cat's box to open.
This simplifies the exploration because we know everywhere we've been able to access up to this point, we've been able to open every box. Should have closed the lid on it as soon as we opened it. I'm not appreciative of cats who do not give us loot.
Velvet is hungry.
I think that would be an excellent use for that cat. This is a very long trip. It'd be funny if this little landing weren't down here. You just jumped into the ocean.
Got swept away by the undercurrent. There's a lot to explore in this city.
I'm pretty sure out of your party, at least Aizen surely knows how to swim.
There's actually a skit about that later on.
If Aizen can't swim, that makes him a very sad pirate.
He forced himself to learn how to swim, but it wasn't... His issues had more to do with the fact that he's an Earth Seraph. Or excuse me. Malik. Apparently they aren't able to swim by default. It's a very difficult thing for them to do.
Whereas we know the ones who are water elemental by default can not only swim, but also find dark bottles.
Craft them, actually. Just very large amounts of them, really. I've prepared the bottles.
Tales of Zestaria, at least a good half of the time that Mikleo's bottle preparation skill went off, it made a dark bottle. And they're completely worthless, so it's pretty tragic.
Excuse me. Let me push into you awkwardly for a little while.
So how do you like our island? Nice and laid back, right?
It's quite a bit different from Logris.
This place was even more relaxed before the opening. But recently, a lot of our young folk have gone starry-eyed about the city and left us in the lurch.
It's still better than it was when the demons first started showing up. We have the Abbey to thank for that. And because people are traveling more now, the need for ships has skyrocketed. Our lumber industry is booming.
In other words, when the money started flowing, people let it go to their heads?
That and those exorcists and soldiers from the bigger cities, they really seemed sophisticated. People from the other islands wear different clothes and have things we don't, you know?
Getting worked up and worked over by what's trendy. Is that foolishness not the very definition of youth?
If this keeps up, our island's traditions will fade away. That's what worries me.
I understand how you feel, but you have to give young people the freedom to be themselves.
We found some rat pig meat. Peony is sad. And that is new. That's a great skill. Its random skill is also good.
And repent your wicked deeds.
Are you talking to me, perchance?
I am. You look so deeply sinful, I wouldn't even know where to begin. Now confess!
Oh, how long have I waited to bear my soul to someone? But I've always lacked the courage. Praise be to the Empyreans who have bestowed upon me this chance today.
Ah, your devotion to the Empyreans is most...
No! It is you who has captured my devotion, my darling! There's no one else I want but you!
What? Me? But my life is in service to the Empyreans, I...
Hush! I want you to look at me the way I look at you! Hold me, darling! Smother me in your embrace!
I don't...
Those were the kind of lines I read in a romance novel. It wasn't even that exciting a book. I wasted so many hours with that piece of trash. Please, forgive me for not putting myself to better use.
Ah! Lying! To a priest! How could you?
Oh, no. I meant to confess my sins, but instead my confession was another sin! Forgive me, Father, I've transgressed once more.
I don't want to forgive you! Come, sinner, and repent your wicked deeds.
Who? Me? I don't think I've done much that needs repenting.
No, my son. You must be mistaken. For I can tell just from how you dress that a great many sins weigh heavily upon your heart. But it's not too late for you yet. You must confess your sins and repent.
Yeah, I hear you, but I really can't think of anything.
Have you ever wielded violence?
No. All I wield are my swords.
Well, have you hurt anybody with your swords?
Yeah, but I haven't been able to land a killing blow yet. I've still got a long way to go. But the next time, I'll kill him.
No, you have it all wrong. You must repent for how you've used your swords.
Oh, I get it. I need to improve my cutting technique, right?
That's not what I meant either.
Ah, and what do you mean? It's a priest's job to guide the layman, right? You'll have to start speaking more clearly if you want anyone to trust your advice. Get your act together, man.
Yes. I'll reflect upon the error of my ways. Wait, what?
I look forward to these feeds for Lafayette, Eleanor, and, Who hasn't been? Oh, Isaac. All three of them could have funny scenes with the priest too. And you know it's coming.
Yeah.
Why do I have a feeling Elidor's is actually going to be the funniest one? I mean, Velvet's was pretty great.
How clueless Rokuro was about the whole thing was pretty incredible.
It's become common practice to use Southgan lumber for shipbuilding, but there's a reason. Our trees really are the best for it.
Natan trees only grow in Southgand. Their wood is light, tough, and doesn't rot. Perfect for shipbuilding.
You know your stuff. Long ago, before people knew how to build seafaring vessels, Midgand and Southgand were separate countries. Then our ancestors fashioned rafts out of Natan logs and floated all the way to Midgand. A Midgand craftsman, amazed to see a humble raft cross the open sea, returned with our ancestors here to Southgand.
He had used the Natant logs to build a large, sturdy ship.
Thanks to him, commerce took off between Midgand and Southgand, and the Age of Exploration began. The excitement of a new age had everyone floating on air, but within mere decades, Midgand declared war on Southgand.
Ironically enough, it was ships made from trees from their islands that enemies used to invade them.
The fighting continued for a long time, but in the end, Midgand emerged the victor. Our islands were occupied. As hard as things were, our ancestors still like to joke about it. They'd say, Age of Exploration, more like Age of Exploitation.
When things were that bad, they could still joke about it?
Southganders have always been a cheerful bunch. We tend to look for the silver lining in every cloud. It may not seem like it these days, but Southgand used to be a place where the laughter would never cease. Some people even used to call it Shenanigand.
Shenanigand. This must have been a really fun place.
Shenanigans is an incredible nickname for any place. That's a lot.
There's a big cluster of them somewhere. I saw, but
that was, I believe, a new crafting material for us. I'm guessing we can buy that tier of equipment here.
I believe so.
We also have a fair bit of redundant equipment we could break down. Another why do they even let you go back here moment?
I mean, there was a search for it.
Yeah, whoopee, we got some garlic. We can be very assured there are no vampires behind that building.
Still no leads on that grimoire lady.
Mogulu, when did you get that letter from her you mentioned?
Hard to say. It must have been last year? A decade ago?
Take this seriously, or I'll feed you to the sharks.
I think I'd at least raid a Kraken.
Keep this up and I swear I'll eat. It's them.
The final preparations are complete. Once you've assumed your new post, everyone will act on your command.
Thank you, sister. But to be honest, I worry that these shoes I'm filling might just be a bit too big for me.
You need not worry. You possess a special strength and quality that others lack. Shepherd Artorias has high hopes for your deployment to Palamedes. Fear not. Just be yourself and you'll do fine. Believe you're a leader, and you will be.
Yes. I'll try to make you proud, sister.
They're sending him to Palamedes? Is that the name of a facility on this island?
I had better get going.
Safe travels.
Two siblings that like each other a little too
much. One
more
thing. Be careful around the demon in Haria. It's stronger than it looks. We've even had some casualties.
Understood.
Also, if you must drink the water, remember to boil it.
Sister...
I know. I worry too much. But I just can't help myself.
So, there's a demon in Haria. Sounds like it's a pretty feisty one, too.
If so, it may prove useful.
Still, what magical timing for Oscar to show up here at the very same hour we do!
I understand your suspicion of me, but have you any proof?
None, it's true. But as an exorcist, you're certainly sympathetic to the Abbey's cause.
And soon you may wish we were sympathetic.
Eleanor hasn't been snitching on us, I'm sure of it.
And how would you know? Are you watching her even when she's taking a bath?
Huh? No, I don't. I always stay outside when she's taking a bath. And...
Then isn't it possible she's communicating with the Abbey in secret while you're not there?
You pledged to obey me until the day you die, correct?
Yes, that I did.
Remember, when you two trade blows, only the Abbey wins.
One less demon, and one less traitor for them to worry about.
While we're standing around here arguing, that demon could be attacking Grimoire!
It's true. Let's find some more people to question around town. So what's it really like?
Huh?
The connection between Moloch and Vessel. Do you share, like, thoughts and feelings?
Sort of. When I'm dwelling inside Eleanor, I can see what she sees and hear what she hears. But I can't read her thoughts or her emotions. Sitting in a box doesn't teach you how the box feels.
I see. In that case, I want to give her as little time alone as possible.
I don't want to bathe with her, all right?
I know. You're a boy and all. For her baths, we can send Bianfu. No, that's a bad idea. It'll have to be Mogulu, or myself.
Phew!
What sort of boundaries have you and Eleanor drawn? How do you sleep?
We talk before bed sometimes, but it's not like I'm sleeping by her side or anything. It's easier for me to tell when she wakes up if I'm dwelling inside her.
Does she ever get out of bed at night?
Not in my experience. And she sleeps so peacefully.
Huh?
When she's around you guys, she always looks so stern. But when she's sleeping, her expression is softer, you could say. She lets her hair down, too. And I think it's kind of prettier that way.
Huh. So that's what he likes. Well, keep an eye on her, but...
But?
Watch out for the older girls.
Huh? Teresa and Oscar sure seem close.
Putting it lightly.
I've known them since I was an initiate, but I've never seen them quarrel. Not even once.
Did you ever fight with your brother, Velvet?
Yeah, I guess I did. Sometimes I'd chew him out, and he'd sulk and stop talking to me, but I found that adorable too.
You did?
No matter how much he dug in his heels, or tried to talk like he was in charge, after a while he'd be right there trailing along behind me.
Like a little puppy dog.
Puppies are a lot more obedient. I always had to keep an eye on him. Little brothers are odd creatures.
Rokuro's a little brother. Is he adorable too?
I don't think a little brother who's out to kill you is in any way adorable.
But Shigure seemed like he was having fun.
Sometimes you just don't make sense.
Huh? I don't know.
Little brothers.
Do you have any siblings?
I'm an only child.
Well then, that's perfect. You pretend the boy is your little brother.
Huh?
That's a bit extreme, but actually, when I'm talking with Lafayette, sometimes I think, this is what having a brother must feel like.
I could be Eleanor's brother.
Don't take any of this nonsense seriously, Lafayette. Malachim are just tools to exorcists. She can never think of you as her brother.
Oh, yeah.
You're wrong. I've changed how I view Malachim. I know that's true because I can think of him as a brother.
Right.
She's all talk. Don't believe her.
It seems to me like you're the one who's treating him as a tool, by forcing your own opinions upon him.
Ooh, two sisters struggling for the affections of their brother. Eeny teeny candlestick, which one will the Muppet pick?
How about an older brother instead?
Velvet's relationship with Lafayette is not what I would call healthy.
I don't think anything about Velvet's psychology is healthy.
The people of Southgand originally worshipped Ominuch, the Empyrean of Water. The lives of the people of the Southern Isles are inherently tied to the sea. Whether it was gratitude for a good catch or an appeal for protection, everyone offered their prayers to Ominuch.
But this the Abbey bothers worships me. Inomina, don't they?
You know why this bothers
me,
right?
Do people still keep their faith?
This
Most
scene?
Of the people obey the
because they keep
the
saying
Abbey.
Ominuch. But one and they would pronounce it Aminok in Zestaria.
The village Consistency. Is called Haria. And even now they keep their faith in Ominuch. They've even quarreled with the Abbey. I'm grateful that they fight off the demons. I really am. But do they have to dictate which gods we worship to?
They think they do. It's their truth. Then again, they can't control what's in your heart, can they?
I like how she was labeled as former believer, but in reality, she's clearly current believer.
Yeah. But that's like that kept bothering me as I was going through this area. They bring up Ominuch, I guess, as they're saying it now, over and over again. I'm like, was pronounced Aminok in the previous game.
You know,
and it's even spelled like that.
It could be pronounced either way given how it's spelled. Aminok is how I would assume it would be. I really want a third game that canonically justifies it by saying most of the records are written and the pronunciations have shifted because different people read it differently. Given the connection between the two worlds, that would be completely plausible. But we know the real reason is just poor translation, and it was exactly the same in the Japanese version.
Yeah. This is a very large town.
There are a lot of minigames in this game.
Well, that's just the card game again.
Its mechanics as cryptic as ever?
Yep.
What does it mean to become an adult?
The eternal question of youth.
Have you ever heard of the ceremony of adulthood? It's a yearly tradition on this island.
If I remember right, it's totally wild. Everyone throws bananas and porringes at each other.
Traditionally, yes, but things have changed over the years. Bananas and porringes are a thing of the past. People are always reaching for bigger and better things, right? In this case, it's watermelons. Whole watermelons.
You're throwing watermelons? That's gotta hurt.
Trust me, I know. But watermelons are the least of our worries. Recently, people have started flinging coconuts.
Coconuts? Those things are as hard as rocks!
Trust me, I know. Like getting hit with a brick. Now, every year, there are some kids who never make it to adulthood.
You don't mean they...
Yeah, I've kept putting it off myself, but it looks like this year I've got no choice but to participate. That's crazy. It's far too dangerous. And more importantly, how does it make someone an adult?
There are ancient traditions that say overcoming danger marks a child's coming of age. Some people still cling to the old ways.
You've hit the nail on the head. There are lots of old folks that sit around complaining how weak as darn kids are. The hypocrites. Back then, they used bananas and watermelons. They even cracked the watermelons ahead of time.
I don't think cracking a coconut would help much either.
So that's why you're standing about looking blue.
I'm so ashamed of myself for being scared.
If you don't want to do the ceremony, why not just skip it?
I'd love to, but I don't really have a choice. I wouldn't be able to show my face around here if I chickened out.
Having the courage to say no to something you don't feel is right. Isn't that the true mark of an adult?
Wait.
You're right! Now I can finally become an adult! Oh, yeah! Look how grown up I am!
And getting carried away with yourself and acting the fool is the true mark of immaturity.
Sorry. You're right.
Kind of stupid village throws coconuts at each other.
I was hoping for pineapples, personally.
Get all those coconut deaths a year. Conversations open up after that scene with siblings on this screen.
The siblings with an overwhelmingly creepy relationship. I really wonder to what extent how creepy their relationship is intentional. Bought her
it's
earrings.
A true shame that Lady Teresa will be leaving our island.
I'm a little relieved, to tell you the truth. She was a bit too strict for a free soul like me.
I guess not even the heat of Southgand could melt her icy cold personality.
But strict as she was also fair. She never asked anyone to do what she wouldn't do herself. Even when we were fighting with Haria Village over the temple, she kept her cool and listened to what they had to say. If it wasn't for her, we'd probably still be squabbling with Haria.
That's true. But did the Abbey really need to take over the temple for themselves?
She was really pretty, too. Sorry to whoever takes her place, but she's the only exorcist for me.
Lady Teresa Linares! You were our protector!
Yeah, we need the chilly charms of the Frozen Queen to cool down the heat in Southgand. Ah, the way those ice-cold eyes of hers looked down at me with disdain, like I was something filthy.
Teresa forever!
Wow, there's one in every town.
Southgan lumber exports have been on the rise, but so has the popularity of Southgan cuisine.
Like Pengyang?
Pengyangs are our flagship food, and our Pengyang farms are flourishing. But porringes, bananas, and our other fruits also sell well.
I've never had any porringes or bananas.
Porringes are sweet but tart and very juicy. They're the perfect refreshment on a hot day.
They're that fruit that glows in the dark, right? Also known as candle fruit?
That's the one. And now bananas. They're soft, sweet, and filling when eaten raw. But if you dry them out, they get crunchy like peanuts. And they stay good for years. South Gand is pretty well off compared to other places. The fish are plentiful, and the trees are heavy with fruit. That's why I'm shipping the excess to other towns.
This guy here, he's a true sailor.
Yeah, good luck. I wish you the best.
Hey, thanks. I appreciate it.
Scout.
I understand why the one scene with the people who love their former abusive dictator opened up after that scene, but I don't know why the other one did. Probably buy both of those. We don't even have enough money, do we? Though we have lots of materials to sell.
Yeah.
Oh, I was selling one of each.
I was hitting the wrong direction.
So what's that one do?
That's the extensions.
So that was totally worth it, even if that equipment wasn't any good.
Hey, this doll? It looks like Bienfu.
Ah, a keen eye you have, young man. That is a doll of the Empyrean Ominoch.
That's Empyrean Ominoch?
Yep, no doubt about it. I've seen her with my own eyes. Real dignified, but not without a bit of a temper.
You saw her? Why was she angry?
Well, the Abbey's banned any profession of the Ominochian faith in Southgand, despite her popularity. Gotta assume that's what got her all bent out of shape. I tried talking to her, but no matter what I said, she was just like, oh.
Wait, that sounds like...
And that low-energy goddess you saw? The doll you've got here looks like her?
Yeah, more or less.
Ha! Fortune smiles upon thee, weary adventurers. That listless goddess is none other than Grim.
Grimoire isn't human?
When did I ever say she was? So, shopkeep, where'd you see her?
I think it was down by McClear Beach.
Pensively watching the tide come in? That's her, all right. Quickly, to the beach!
Okay, we need to look into several things.
I'm equipping one of these right now. You see what the ability is, right?
So that makes you red charge faster?
Yep.
And it's better stats than what you had, right?
Yeah.
I think Aizen is the one working on boots that don't have a relevant ability. Or no, not Aizen. Rokuro, isn't it?
Well...
Or no, Eleanor.
Yeah.
So, okay, we have those. What's your current ability you're working on? It is really good. That one does improve your speed of learning everything else.
Yeah.
He's very close to mastering wind attack plus 4%. Yeah, we gotta master the Floric Boots.
Super Child learned yet, Superboy?
Why didn't you mention Grimoire as a Moloch before
we
now?
We need to enhance
you
equipment
too. You can't
be
too careful with that information.
Our goal should be to both unlock skills and try to get the important characters to plus 5. He's about to switch weapons off that, so...
Yeah. How far along is he?
He's not gonna be long for that weapon either.
That's... worth... so...
Her boots too. Both set of boots should probably be enhanced if we can. So you're looking at her belt.
Oh wait, it's gonna be accessories.
And that's also worth it for another reason.
Yeah.
We cannot enhance those because we don't have any more amp and pole fragments.
So we got a lot of duplicate stuff, so... yeah.
The bottom two are the garbage ones, right?
Yeah.
What's his current Floric bag have? The one that he has equipped.
Oh. Much.
Oh yeah, the other two are totally dismantled.
Both of these, you think?
I mean, it's a garbage ability we're only using when we have nothing else, you know?
Yeah. But I remember its stats are decent, but...
Thank you. Why did she have the
worst one?
Yeah.
Maybe someone else had it equipped at the time.
Likely.
Not enhance. Dismantle.
We don't really need a lot of those materials, though.
These shock words get us amphibole fragments.
Which are useful. And again, Mogaloo has the worst one equipped right now. So we probably want to rotate.
Yeah. At least calcite boots we have.
Yeah, calcite boots have about run out their usefulness other than keeping one pair around. Same with all those amber boots, really. Okay, we should enhance those Ampharos boots, because we're going to be using those for quite a while. That's really interesting that the one triggered that, not the other. That really is an excellent set of boots Velvet has right now.
Okay, what are the best abilities we can get off stuff?
Stuff that just requires really cheap materials has value too, unless we're just about to switch off them. Because, you know... I think we're going to be using the two Floric Waistcoats for a while, and it's just adding levels to Lafayette and Aizen.
Yeah.
And look at that. Extra experience from defeating beasts. 20% extra, actually.
That's really good.
So Velvet's at
something here.
I thought you were just going to check what level every character was at this point. Because we're aiming for plus 5. Velvet's at plus 4, so...
Why are you thinking plus 5?
Isn't plus 5 when you get the extra level of a... Because we had a point where Mogaloo was worth 4 blasts, so...
Well, that's I mean, that's really easy to check.
Yep. So now Velvet can hold 4 blasts, which is actually pretty nice, you know?
Yeah. And Who else is close?
That's what I thought you were going to look at. Oh, by the way, look at the flame ward that Eleanor has. It might not be the best flame ward we have. Like, that's just obviously a lot better. Eleanor is at 3. That flame ward's really good. It's going to be on someone for a long time.
Halbert's new, too. We might as well just get her to 5, right?
Yeah. The flame ward. Aizen's at 3, Lophiset's only at 2, and though the floric bag might be good to improve just because the effect on improving it is so nice, you know?
Yeah. We do have to take into account our resources a little bit.
Look at how many fragments we have.
I was looking at money.
Oh, we still have 2,000. These are relatively cheap.
That should be everything.
So now all the relevant characters can hold an extra blast.
Yep.
At least for now. But that's not a bad thing, is it?
Nope.
And that's just a lot of extra stats. One thing we do need to do before the next boss is deal with all our art mappings.
Oh, yeah. And this is not a long dungeon.
How do you trigger the extensions?
I honestly don't know, because it's all just moves you already know.
That's, like, important to know. Like, have you never done it?
No, I just use the move that I want to use.
You should look in the battle book to see if it tells you.
Let's see if this is the move I think it is. If it is, I want to use it a lot. Okay, you're thinking... It might be... What's the item?
It's one of the Ventites, so... That has its own jar. Or it's... Yeah, Patentite, I guess. Whatever. Under certain conditions. That's not helpful. But now I know the name of the item. Don't know how to do Control F on this thing. There's some weird specific input you're supposed to do to Control F on a phone. I don't remember what it is.
Mine just has a bind in the upper right hand corner. Every phone I've had has been like that. Okay, Stone Lance there. Quickness there. Coercion there.
You just hold the button.
Oh. Under certain conditions, right?
Like, that was, and by the way, the only place I was finding that information was just a chaotic 4chan thread, so I've really suffered to bring this information to us.
Do you want to set stuff?
You understand my feelings, right?
Yeah.
So that alters to Frozen Flame. That's funny because that's like his... The main thing I would want it to alter to is, in fact, Frozen Flame. Okay, what's the button to do that?
Just where it says next, just go all the way down. Go. On the, stick, yeah. Sorry, you don't do it with the D-pad.
So I want that one there, and that one. This is just four different moves, all of which stun. That seems like a useful general purpose combo.
Yeah.
I don't know very many moves right now. Honestly, doesn't even matter. I'm not going to use those options. It's a shame some of these don't alter into moves we don't have yet, because that would be helpful.
I don't think they're capable of it.
I don't think they are either. But wouldn't it be really helpful if they were? Thank you. Skewering spear is actually really good.
Is skewering spear your thrust?
Yes. I need a bigger art pool to take advantage of my ability to actually map my character. You know the feeling? Like, it was so limiting before, but suddenly there's freedom.
Beautiful.
I feel like I've heard all of this dialogue a ton already here. How much time I spent with the demo.
Waters. So this is Mockler Beach.
I hope she's actually here.
That's nice. At this point, those are precious.
Yeah.
We have one for 170 sitting in town. We'll probably be able to open that one before we finish this dungeon, or shortly thereafter, perhaps.
This grimoire who we're searching for is a Moloch like Bienfu, right? To be honest, I don't see how someone so different can be a Moloch just the same as Lafayette or Aizen.
I understand your doubts. It's quite the tangly mess. I'll tell you anything!
In that case, I've been wondering, what's underneath your hat?
Oh, no! Anything but that!
So, we've hit a wall already.
But that ribbon flaps around and gets in the way, right? Could I take it off for you?
No! No! That's not possible! You mustn't remove the ribbon!
Why not?
That's another thing I can't say!
It's all cans with you. All right, is there anything you can tell me?
I could talk about what type of Malakim we are, or our position in the world of Malakim, or our abilities.
Oh, I'd like to know all that.
Then I will tell you. Listen closely. We Norman are a well-established race of Malakim. Compared to other Malakim, we aren't as adept at manipulating natural forces, but we excel at drawing out and heightening the abilities of others.
Think of them as a convenient power-up.
They're also known as common spirits.
Don't even say that! We Norman hate being called that!
Why is it so painful for you?
Because it makes people think we're average and unremarkable! That's why we work so hard to show how we're all different!
That does explain your quirky speaking mannerisms.
Don't sweat it. That's a perfectly common thing to worry about.
Don't say that!
That seems funnier after the Infu's just history of abuse.
No one stands up for the Infu, not even Eleanor.
Well, Lafayette's not as cruel to the Infu as everyone else.
But he won't stand up for Bienfu.
He's not really the type to stand up for anyone. Your party's pretty big bullies, and he lets you get away with a lot. I mean, I guess he does suggest Velvet not kill people at a couple points. He's all heart. I bet this is familiar.
What are those penguins doing?
Probably keeping their eggs warm.
Most likely. They look like a mama and a papa. Penguins are monogamous, faithful creatures. They never leave their mate. Isn't that romantic?
So they lay eggs because they're like husband and wife. But how do they make the eggs?
That's... well...
So, Laffy said, here's an interesting fact. A single penguin egg actually contains dozens of smaller orange eggs.
Oh, so their eggs must be small and crunchy.
Yep. They have the texture of caviar and the rich flavor of sea urchins.
Interesting. So they're more like fish than birds.
So you've eaten them. How cruel. Look how much they care about their young.
While it may be a bit cruel, they taste amazing. They're considered a delicacy in some circles. Top a bowl of rice with these crunchy eggs and some rich penguin thigh meat, and you get a dish called family fricassee.
That's a horrific name.
I wasn't the one who named it, okay?
Those eggs look tasty, but I think I'll pass.
Scout ship.
Did we get the recipe from the Norman Islands?
Yeah, we did.
So this one's worth experience, right?
Yep.
It's still the bottom recipe. We haven't looked at what the Norman recipe does. It's probably worthless. That is not worthless, but not as good as the other one. It takes a very long time to actually master cooking. That's gonna be a fun post-game grind, right?
Yep. There will probably be efficient ways to do a lot of this stuff.
I think you can just cook over and over again, so it's about farming the ingredients, right?
Hopefully.
She's moving away!
That noise is